There was something. No. Everything different about him. Town after town, crowds after crowds. The carpenter turned healer, forgiver, miracle worker. And when he taught, people listened. It wasn't the pompous, pious dribble of the scribes. His guarantee was simple. Blessed are you who are pure of heart, for you will see God. And he taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day the bread of our needs. Forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. This was straight-level theology that defined his ministry. No wonder everywhere we went, the people were anxious to hear, to see, to touch. Just the hem of his garment, but nothing like one wonderful Sunday. We were on our way to Jerusalem to celebrate the feast. Thousands were already with us. Thousands come rushing out from the city to greet us. It was unbelievable. Children were running and playing. People were singing and dancing. They took their coats off, laid them on the street in front of Jesus. They were waving palm branches and they were shouting, "Hallelujah!" Just what we've been waiting for. Everyone agrees. This must be Messiah. But the Roman soldiers quickly dispersed the crowd, and who could blame them? There were rumors and threats of danger that filled the city. The 12 of us just wanted to be safe, away from the turmoil, and retreat to our upper room. Finally, a time of coming together to celebrate the first day of the feast of unleavened bread, James and John hovering over Jesus. Thaddeus and Matthew engaged in some fine point of teaching. Philip and Nathanael just glad to be together, while the Canaanite and Thomas kept watch over Judas, who was trying to impress us when Jesus shocked us. There is one sitting at this table that is about to betray me. My betrayer is the one with whom I dipped this bread, and he dipped with Judas Iscariot. And he sent Judas from the room. The familiar table was set. No one could expect. Everything was about to change.
There was something about this holy night, in the stillness and the candlelight. The time had come to hear the final plan. One by one we filled the room, simple men in search of truth, giving up our lives for this man. And once the bread and wine became a picture to us all, he wrapped a towel around him, pouring water in a bowl. And from the place of honor that was given as his seat, the one who calmed the waters began to wash our feet. Will you remember the love we share as friends? Even though you can't come with me now, I know we'll meet again. Will you remember that the Father is in me? And when I go, I'll come for you to take.
Will I remember? I'm flooded in memories, the last 3 years just flashing through my mind as we left the room that night. And then we left the city. We crossed the Kidron Valley and climbed the Mount of Olives, overlooking the garden from Gethsemane. Jesus asked James and John and me away from the others. We went a little farther to pray. When they came, they dragged him to Pilate's palace, intent to get a decree to kill him. They would stop at nothing to rid themselves of his threat to their lifestyle. Pilate himself was torn between political pressure and personal opinion, so he asked the crowd, "What shall I do with you, King of the Jews?" Pilate washed his hands of the whole affair. Well, I warmed mine outside by the fire until a servant girl saw me. "You were with this Jesus." "No, I was not." "Yes, I saw you with Jesus." "I said I was not." "You liar. You're one of his disciples." "I said I was not." "You swine. I tell you, I don't know the man." The last I saw of Jesus, he was dragging himself and his own cross to his own death.
Walking on the road to Jerusalem, the time had come to sacrifice again. My two small sons, they walked beside me on the road. The reason that they came was to watch the Lamb. "Daddy, Daddy, what will we see there? There's so much that we don't understand." So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, "Dear children, watch the Lamb. There will be so many in Jerusalem today. We must be sure the Lamb doesn't run away." Then I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, "Dear children, watch the Lamb." When we reached the city, I knew something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers, no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. Then I heard the crowd cry out, "Crucify him!" Part I did not wish to play. Why upon this day are men condemned to die? Why are we standing here when soon they would pass by? I looked and said, "Even now they come." The first one cried for mercy, the people gave him none. The second one was violent. He was arrogant and loud. I still can hear his angry voice screaming at the crowd. And someone said, "There's Jesus." I scarce believe my eyes. A man so badly beaten, he barely looked alive. Blood poured from his body, from the thorns upon his brow, running down the cross and falling to the ground. I watched him as he struggled. I watched him as he fell. the cross came down upon his back, the crowd began to yell. In that moment I felt such agony. In that moment I felt such loss. Until a Roman soldier grabbed my arm and screamed, "Go! I tried to resist him, then his hand reached for his sword. And so I knelt and took the cross from the Lord, placed it on my shoulder, started down the street. The blood he'd been shedding came running down my cheek. They led him to Golgotha. They drove nails deep in his feet and hands. Yet upon the cross, I heard him say, 'Father, forgive them. Oh, never have I seen such love in any other eyes. Into thy hand I commit my spirit.' He prayed. And then he died. I stood for what seemed like years, had lost all sense of time, until I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the older say, 'Father, please forgive us. The lamb ran away.' Daddy, daddy, what have we seen here? So much we just don't understand. So I held them in my arms. We turned and faced the cross. Then I said, 'Dear children, watch the Lamb.'"
trembled, and the tomb began to shake, and like lightning from heaven, the stone rolled away, and its dead men, the guards, fled.
What a magnificent scene, an incredible event in our history. A loving God looking down upon us from heaven, knowing that we're in need of Him. And at just the right time, He steps into history, more importantly, into our lives. Every Christmas, I'm humbled to realize that God loves us so much that He sent His one and only Son for me and for you. That's what Christmas is really all about. That's why He came to the lowly manger in Bethlehem. Because He loves us. Well, the very name Emmanuel means simply God with us. We celebrate God's gift to us by giving Christmas gifts to one another. That wonderful tradition began as a result of God giving us the gift of eternal life, made possible through His Son. It's a gift for us to receive. We can't buy it, we can't earn it, and we certainly don't deserve it. But a gift is not a gift until you receive it. Jesus said it this way, "I stand at the door of your heart and knock. And if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I'll come into him." That's what it means to receive Christ, the gift of God. I trust you'll do that this Christmas. As a matter of fact, even right now, I can lead us in a prayer, and you can pray that simple prayer and receive God's gift of eternal life. Would you join with me in prayer? Just pray this prayer in your heart. Dear Jesus, I thank you for the gift of eternal life. I believe that you are the Savior. I thank you for dying on the cross for my sin. By faith, I invite you to come into my life, and I receive you as my Savior. Thank you for this wonderful gift. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I imagine that many of you have questions about receiving Christ as Savior and Lord. And so please contact us. Do me a favor. write or call the numbers that you see on your screen. I'll personally send you a booklet that will help you as you begin to walk on this new path of life. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you, and have a very Merry Christmas.